We represent to you Iskandar Waterfront Holdings.
Okay, Assalamualaikum and very good morning to my fellow employees. Our company name is Iskandar Waterfront, that located in Johor Bahru. Okay, today we discuss our objective, our goals, vision, mission, and continuous planning. Okay, Khairul, please tell me about company goals.
The company goal, the Iskandar was listed in 2006 inside a big consultant, a peninsula minister in more development regions, where list items in government and business service government with the Basin and Vibrant Metropolis. Located at the southmost tip of peninsula Malaysia, Iskandar Malaysia is strategically positioned on the world business shipping route. Covering an area of 2.17 square kilometer approximately 3 times the size of Singapore. Iskandar Malaysia offers significant supply of land which is comfortably delegated as ready infrastructure such as power, utility, transport network and survey and robust telecommunication. Based in Italy of Malaysia Federal Government along with the Johor State Government, Iskandar Malaysia vision to be a strong sustainable metropolitan interested study has the Malaysia vision to be strong and sustainable metropolis of international study as the continued commitment support and sponsorship of the government of the country and state.
Thank you, Harold. Okay, we move to objective company. Yassir, please.
Some for objectives are faith in petty toward God, just and trustworthy government, free and liberated people, a rigorous pursuit and mastery knowledge, a balanced and comprehensive economic development, a good quality of life for the people, protection of the right of minority group and women, cultural and moral integrity, safeguarding of the environment, strong defended capabilities.
Thank you, Yassir. We will discuss about vision and mission. Zach?
Yes, sir.
Please describe about your...
Well, sir, about the our companies, which is the Iskandar Waterfront City Berhad, its mission is to become a leading integrated property developer and builder that focuses on community living and quality development. We can see that our company is trying to build as much building as we can afford to build, but we may try to maintain its green scenery as well as possible. Well, for the mission of our company is to build a sustainable development area that promotes quality and innovative products and excellent services that meet customers' needs and ultimately ensuring equitable shareholders' returns. About the mission, we receive numerous type of investment, either from the local parties or the foreign investors.
Okay, Zach, how about crisis in 2008?
Well, about the crisis that you have mentioned just now, sir, we can see that during 2008, our company was experiencing its general election. And as well as during 2008, the global world were also experiencing this kind of global financial crisis. This global economic crisis did not just affect our company, it also affect all around the world, almost companies all around the world. And according to our head of business and investment department, Mr. Nur Azwar Muhammad, he told me that there are only 2 or 3 visits per week from foreign investors that came to our company compared to the previous period, which is the earlier 2008, where on daily basis there are around 2 or 3 visits from foreign or local investors. And due to this political instability as well as the global financial crisis, this situation had worsened day by day. And Mr. Noazwa also suggested to me that the government should provide our company more fund to increase our investments in getting more profits. Besides, he also explained to me that Although Western parties were no longer interested in investing in our company, there are also some Middle Eastern companies that are still interested to invest in our company, such as the Abu Dhabi Investment Agency, Mubadala Development Corporation, and Aldar Properties. Besides, our parent company, Iskandar Malaysia, was also collaborating with some foreign giant companies such as Disney in building some theme parks, 2 or 3 theme parks in Iskandar area. That's all from me, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Zack. We go to continuous planning. Okay, Aslam.
Yes. Yeah, your turn. Yes, to ensure our company stability, I started some of our continuous planning and future development. For our first project is Legoland in Malaysia. It is the first developing township of Medin Iskandar. Gained global interest when the master developer in 2007 signed with Legoland from the United Kingdom to develop its first theme park in this region. With its vast landscape, Medini was a choice location for the chain theme park operator. Since its opening in 2012, the theme park is known to have drawn families residing in Johor, Malaysia, as well as foreign visitors from Singapore and the region. Last year, the theme park completed its regular water theme park and hotel, which is expected to bring more visitors to the locality. Then, our second project is Flagship A, Johor Bahru City. The city of Johor Bahru is Malaysia's southern gateway, receiving 60% of foreign tourists who visit Malaysia. It is major holiday and shopping destination for neighbouring Singaporeans due to the comparatively lower cost of goods and services. Johor Bahru is the central business district and the state capital of Johor. It is also the main gateway into and out of Singapore. The current key economic activity in Flagship A are financial services, commerce and retail, arts and culture, hospitality, urban tourism, plastic manufacturing, electrical and electronics and food processing. In the future, a multi-modal terminal will be developed in Flagship A, as well as an LRT system connecting Johor Bahru City to the other areas in Iskandar Malaysia. Then, our last project is Flagship D, Eastern Gate Development. As one of the key components of Iskandar Malaysia, the industrial and manufacturing hub in the southern region of Peninsula Malaysia encompasses 31,132 hectares of the Pasir Gudang area. Flagship D covers Pasir Gudang Port, Pasir Gudang Industrial Park, Tanjung Langsat Port and Tanjung Langsat Industrial Complex. Current key economic activities in Flagship D are focused on heavy industries and logistics, including in electrical and electronics, chemical, oleochemical, food and engineering, best industries as well as ports and logistics and warehousing. Flagship D has the largest concentration of palm oil refining industries and downstream activities in the world. Most land banks in Flagship D are industrial zone, less than 30 plus 30 years lease or 60 year lease, and residential type, freehold and leasehold. That's all for the continuous planning. So thank you.
Okay, thank you, Aslam. We just heard the project mega on our company that will earn highest profit. So thank you for your commitment and corporate. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.